Zidane record.
Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Hello everyone, my name is Adi Bianti. Today, I will present my presentation about an article that called I Survived Coronavirus. So let's start. Next slide, please. So the article tells us about someone who have survived coronavirus. It began when they went to a Mexican restaurant along island that Friday night, and they served lots of logs and food. The news was just beginning to revert to spread of COVID-19 in America, so it wasn't exactly at the forefront of her mind. She had body aches and a minor fever for 5 days, but it didn't seem a cause for concern. But she's still working in the midst of chaos. In fact, they received twice as many deliveries from China that week, as its factories were back up and finally running began. With people in the office began to get something that seemed like a cold virus, but most of them still keep coming to work. Her symptoms began on Monday, March 16. It had been a week since Luis had been sick. It all began with a low fever about 99 to 100 degrees on Thursday. The headache started. The pain was mainly behind her eyes, like a very, very heavy sinus headache. By the end of the week, she felt a bit disoriented, and the headache became debilitating. Luis and she decided it was to the time that seek medical help. She was confident that she would contract it from Luis. And the peak start when her fever spiked to 101.8 degrees, and she couldn't sleep and lost her sense of taste and smell. And then looking back, she really wished that people had taken the virus more seriously earlier. She know a lot of doctors are talking about possibly having immunity after contracting the virus, but she's still wearing a mask in public from now on. She know they say the media blows things out the proportion, but that's not true with this. This was really painful, and they got lucky. And then next slide, please. In my opinion, it is related with the current condition. Many people have struggled to recuperate from the coronavirus, even though there are still many victims in Indonesia. Around 5,000 people have recovered. So if we want to fight to recover and live a normal life again, then we can and always obey the government and help the vertical migration and don't give up easily. Okay, I will make a question session. There are 3 questions. Any question from you guys?
Aurora, please.
Okay, Aurora, your question.
My question is, what fear did he felt at that time?
Okay, I will answer your question. And she feared that she would be forced to fight a help and that there would not be enough doctors, nurses, ventilators, or beds. And she is also afraid there is no cure and no vaccine, or maybe die alone in the hospital. Did I answer your question clearly, Aurora?
Yes, thank you, Ade.
Next question, please.
Divya, please.
Okay, Divya, your question.
Okay, thank you. I want to ask, what is the moral value contained in the article? Thank you.
Okay, thank you, Divya, for your question. So the answer is we must be careful and always take care of our health and cleanliness. Also, during the COVID-19 pandemic, and obey the government and the governmental regulation so that COVID-19 will end quickly without sacrificing many victims. Okay, Divya, did I answer your question clearly?
Yes. Thank you.
Next question, please.
Can I, Ade?
Okay, Tita.
My question is, what did she, when she was infected by the coronavirus?
Okay, I will answer your question. Her fever about 102.8 degrees. She cannot sleep, hips and cleaning back pains, loss of taste and smell, stomachache and dry chalk, and also he had a headache. Did I answer your question clearly, Rita?
Yes, thank you, Ade.
Okay, I think her connection is bad. I think it's enough for my presentation. Thank you for your kind attention. And assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.